Good afternoon, students. Do you know what our class is now? It's fluid mechanics. The moment, instant mechanics. In the first year, already we have studied engineering mechanics. Mechanics is a basic branch of physics which deals with the response of the object due to forces in rest and moving condition. So engineering mechanics, basic mechanics is divided into three categories. One is mechanics of rigid bodies. The second one is mechanics of deformable bodies. And the third one is mechanics of the fluids. What is a rigid body? Any substance which does not deform, that means which does not change its shape or size due to the applied force, is known as a rigid body. Engineering mechanics is the rigid body mechanics. That means in engineering mechanics we presume that due to the applied force there will not be any change in the shape or dimensions of the object. So mechanics of the deformable bodies is called mechanics of solids or strength of materials. So due to the applied force, so there will be some change either in the length or area or the volume of a body. So whenever there is a change in shape or size of a body, so the mechanics related to that is coined under mechanics of deformable bodies, which is strength of materials or mechanics of solids. Mechanics of solids. So here, for the solids, we are having rigid body mechanics and deformable bodies mechanics, and separately, the mechanics of fluids are categorized separately as fluid mechanics. Because whenever a force is applied on a solid body or a fluid, its response will be different. For example, suppose if I spin a cricket ball or a tennis ball on a table, it will spin very regularly. The movement will be very smooth and it is regular. And if I spin an egg which consists of the fluid inside, if I spin it on the same table, we can observe some discontinuities in the motion and jerks. So from this, it is very clear that whenever some force is applied on a body, the solids will be behaving in a different manner and liquids will be behaving in a different manner. So that's why solids are basically classified as rigid body mechanics, which is engineering mechanics, and deformable body mechanics, that is nothing but strength of materials or mechanics of the solids, and the mechanics of the fluids, mechanics of the fluids is the another state of the matter. Matter is divided into three states, that is solids, liquids and gases. So I can state that matter is divided into two states. One is solid and other is fluids. A fluid is either liquid or a gas. Both liquids and gases are put together are known as fluid. So this is the basic definition of fluid from general perspective of physical sciences. Similarly, a fluid is a substance which is capable of flowing. Fluid is a substance which is capable of flowing. And also, a fluid can be also defined as a substance which can exhibit a free surface between an interface of another fluid. So it can, which can exhibit a free surface. That means, free surface means it is united with the symbol. Suppose if you have a liquid like this, so this is the liquid level and this is the which means that the pressure exerted on the surface is atmospheric pressure. So a fluid is a substance which can exhibit a free surface. This is also the definition on the general perspective. So coming to the engineering perspective, so what are the different types of the forces? So normal forces, so generally the normal force, if the force is acting perpendicular to the surface, it is known as the normal force, and the force upon area is nothing but the stress. So the normal forces can be either tensile, which will elongate the body, or which can be compressive, compression forces, which will shorten the body. So this is when a force is acting in a normal direction. When a force is acting inclinally to the surface, this force can be resolved into two components. One is the normal component and other is the parallel component, that is the tangential component. So the component of the force which is parallel to the surface or tangential to the surface is known as the shear force. The shear force divided by the acted area is nothing but the shear stress. So here makes the difference between a solid and the fluid. Solid can withstand a very little, liquids can withstand a very little of tensile forces, and a liquid can withstand a compressive force, whereas shear force, the liquid cannot withstand a shear force. So based on this, a fluid on the engineering perspective is defined as a fluid is a substance which deforms continuously due to the applied shear stress, no matter how small the shear stress may be. A liquid, it doesn't mean that liquid cannot resist the shear stress. So it will, whatever may be the small amount of the shear force is applied on a fluid, it will respond to it and it will deform continuously. So let us understand this having a small example. Let us consider two parallel plates extending over infinite extent, and liquid is confined, water is confined in between these two parallel plates, and it is extended to infinite extent. Okay, so the lower plate is depressed, and I apply a force F in this direction, and with that it will acquire a velocity V. So the lower plate is depressed and the upper plate will be in motion. Okay, so due to no slip condition or inertia, so the particle of the fluid which is surrounding the plate, so it will stick or adhere onto the plate, and due to inertia it will acquire a velocity V. And a layer just below that fluid, what will it do is, so as the layer, the fluid particle which is sticking onto the plate is moving with a velocity V, a layer just below it will tend to oppose the motion of that, so that here a velocity variation, or we call velocity gradient, is obtained and depends upon the shear stress and also the distance between the plates, while it may be linear or parabolic or any other shape, that depends upon the shear stress or the distance between the plates. Okay, so from here we can define a fluid. So how small the shear force is applied, which is parallel to the plate, the liquid will definitely deform and there will be some shear strain theta. So the liquid which is originally like this slowly will deform like this, so there will be some shear strain. So we can say the liquid can be defined, fluid can be defined as a substance which deforms continuously